Project, and I'm here with Belle. And she is with Field of Yoga Project as well. We are going to demonstrate for you a conditioning sequence that we use in our Peak Flow program. And join in and do it. This is it's got great core strengthening and hip opening, and some excellent upper body work. And you can think of these conditioning sequences as ways to get to a specific arm balance. So in this case, this is a good one for arm balances like Tadasana, the one in which you have a wide straddle position and you balance on your hands and take your feet off the ground. That's what we're using it for with our current session. Okay, so we're gonna start off on our belly and in a pose called Shalabhasana. So come onto your mat and lay out and interlace your fingers behind your back. And then lift everything up. Okay, awesome. On an inhale, you can take the legs as wide as you possibly can, trying to push through heel sides. Exhale, taking the legs together. So inhale, as wide of a straddle as you can get, and exhale, taking them together. We're gonna do 5 times. So be sure that you're keeping a good strong lift in the upper body at the same time, contracting the muscles of the back. We're gonna end with the 5th time, leaving the legs wide. So leave your legs wide, set your legs down, and now we're gonna plank on the forearms. Plank on the forearms with the legs wide. Okay, awesome. So keep the space behind the heart, dropping it. This is also, you can think of it like chest is lowering down the arm bones. We'll be here about 5 breaths. This is awesome positioning in the back body. Do not tilt your pelvis forward. That will cause your low back to strain. So Val has got excellent form here. You're gonna feel this in a lot of places, right?
Yes.
Okay, so once we get to about 5 breaths, then we lower and we repeat the exact same thing. Interlace the fingers behind the back. Lift everything up, inhale, take the legs really wide. And then exhale, squeezing them together. So inhale, abduction, exhale, adduction. If you push out through the heel side of your foot rather than the toe side, that's kind of what I'm looking for the hip activation that I want. Because you want to warm up certain parts of your body so that you can stretch them better. So 5 times there, and then a 5 breath hold here again. So integrity, if you do start to lose integrity in this pose and you start to feel like you are collapsing, then lift your hips a little higher. It's better to do that than it is to let them hang too low, because then you lose integrity of the low back, and ultimately that's going to cause a lot of trouble and pain. So about 5 breaths here. And you can do this 5 and 5 part of the sequence as many times as you like. As we work through our programs, we add on. So we would add more on. But now what we're gonna do, we're gonna stop with it, and we're gonna take hold of our feet. So bend both knees, take hold of your feet. This might not be easy for everybody, it's very easy for Val, but we can find different ways with straps to get a hold of the feet. And now she's gonna just try to push her heels towards the floor outside of her hips. And if you wanted to get even deeper with it, you could allow a lot more internal rotation of your thigh, because when you internally rotate your thigh, right, if I'm here, I can go this far, but if I internally rotate it, my foot will get closer to the floor. And so you decide how you want to work with that, because it kind of depends on which quads you want to get. And then push your knees back strongly while you're doing it, because you can then involve more of your quads, no matter which way you're choosing to do it. Okay, more of the full length of the quad muscle. So go ahead and release that. Okay, and so some more wide leg work. From here, we're gonna come into a down dog, however you like. If you wanna plank it or do whatever, you're gonna get there and you're gonna take your feet wide in a down dog. So this is a twisting down dog, and we're gonna move in and out of it on the breath. So take your right hand back outside of your left calf. Oh, sorry, it's inside. No, I'll try to go outside. Is that what we normally do?
I don't know.
I think so, yeah, go outside, definitely. Okay, so on the inhale, bend your knee. And then on the exhale, straighten your knee and twist yourself through more. Yeah, like that. So inhale is bending, and exhale is straighten, and try to turn yourself up more. So the other arm is really just trying to maintain the extension. And you're getting a twisting aspect, and you're getting a lot of strengthening through, you know, this one-armed down dog. So about 5 of those, and then we extend it back out into a down dog, And then we're gonna go right to the other side. So we reach back with the left hand outside. Yep, uh-huh. And then we inhale and bend the knee, and we exhale and turn it up. Awesome. Depending on what you might have done yesterday, if you went running at 5:30 a.m. like Val did, then you know you might feel a lot of these things more than normal. But yoga can always help you work out of those soreness issues anyway. That's why I'm making her do it the second time today. She did it in class at 5:30 a.m. So five of those on the breath, and then we come to this down dog. Okay, so next up is we're gonna really super warm up the hips. And in order to do that, so Val, how about just take your right foot forward on the mat and turn yourself to face left. And it's gonna be this lungy thing. So you're gonna bend into your right knee and extend your spine straight. Okay, actually, come on up. It's not even the transverse lunge, you got it. So we're gonna take a straddle first, got it?
Yeah.
Okay, and you can take this particular straddle as wide as you want. And then bend into your right knee, and now push into your right heel and lift your upper body up, take your arms wide. Super. So we're gonna hold it there for five breaths, and you're gonna have a lot of heating happening in your right hip. To help you use the complex of the back of your leg, if you push through your right heel, you're gonna get more engagement of things like your glutes and your glute meds. And that's what we want to do to support this pose. So she's pushing forward through her chest. She's doing great. She's counting her five breaths. And then she gets to release and shift to the other side. So part of what we do here is just like really quick ways to heat and strengthen parts of the body. So you can get through the sequence in under 15 minutes, and that's what these conditioning sequences are designed for. And then you can be really prepared to stretch these areas very deeply. On top of that, you're getting a lot of strength, a lot of bang for your buck when it comes to strength. So she's breathing five breaths, she's pushing her heel down, she's pushing her chest forward, her alignment is great, I don't have to do anything. It's typical of Val, who is a trained yoga teacher as well, and we like yoga. We hang out together. We hung out together first because of yoga. Now we hang out together because of biking. So don't believe that running stuff. Okay, so the next thing that we do is a wide leg straddle, and then she's gonna walk her hands underneath and through, and she's gonna point her fingers back. Now, this is where I'm gonna ask you to use the leverage of walking your hands as far through as you can to get as deep as you can. This is really similar to the position you're in that arm balance I mentioned, Tiddhivasana. So we work this way to prepare ourselves for later. So maybe a 3 to 5 breaths there. Then we're gonna switch into a little bit more upper body work. Okay, walking the hands to the front of your mat, you're gonna step it back into a plank. Okay, so these are one-legged vinyasas going through up dog. Inhale, take your right leg off the mat, heel to the height of the hip. Exhale, bend your right knee. Inhale, dip into up dog on one leg. Exhale, knee to chest core plank pose. Inhale, extend back onto the plank. And exhale, bend at the knee. Inhale, dipping, and then exhale, knee to chest. Okay, so you can do that as many times as you want. You wanna do one more?
Just one more.
She's gonna do one more. Okay, earlier in class, she didn't wanna. The knee comes to the chest. Extend it out, and then take a down dog. Okay, so before we do the other side, it's kind of nice to symmetrize. So she's gonna go from down dog to up dog several times. Inhale straight through to up dog. Notice she's not doing any chaturanga, she's not having to bend her elbows. Exhale into the down dog. And do that a few more times. Try to keep inhale and exhale the same length. And I often will ask students to let the breath compel the movement. This means you're gonna wait until your breath begins, until you begin to move your body. Yeah. Okay, so let's take the down dog and take a breath. Feel like we've got a little bit more evenness left and right in the body, and then come out to the plank again. So we'll do three on this side. So the inhale is take the left heel off the mat, exhale, bend the knee. Inhale, dipping, lifting chest, exhale, knee to chest. Two more of those. Inhale, extend one-legged plank, exhale to bend the knee. Inhale, chest upward, one-legged up dog, and then exhale, core plank. One more time. So when the fatigue happens, let the hips just come a little bit higher in your planking, okay? All right, so back to the down dog. All right, so yes, you have a choice of how many of these you want to do, and you learn every time you try. Let's come through to an up dog and to a down dog, but then we will do one or two up dog, chaturanga, up dog, down dogs, okay? Because this is what I typically will do in a lot of my sun salutes. Inhale through to up dog, okay? Exhale to chaturanga, so then the, yep, shoulders stay lifted. Inhale to the up dog, she's got it, and exhale to the down dog, okay? So again, you can do as many of these depending on how much work you need in building the upper body strength of chaturanga. We do a decent amount of it as we flow through our full class. Exhale, chaturanga. So she's keeping the frontal shoulders lifted, which is super important, and I can talk more about that in a chaturanga tutorial. Okay, so that's what we got for you for the conditioning sequence, that's it. And then if you wanna see more, check out what else we have to offer. We have other sequences that help you either continue to build towards arm balances like Tiddhasana, or help you in all kinds of different ways for different poses.